Break in North America's trucking industry, and its epicenter is right here on East 33rd Street, east of Post Road. Recruiters for other companies sat in the rain, signing up laid-off truck drivers, as Celadon Trucks and the people who drive them are coming to a halt.
Celadon's done, and they told us today that they have to close by court order, and that they're giving them out bus tickets. So I gave them my name for a bus ticket.
Celadon's Chapter 11 reorganization bankruptcy shows it has assets of $427 million, debts of $391 million, and its biggest unsecured claim is $33 million owed in restitution to the federal government. As the result of ongoing probes into fraud committed by former Celadon executives who allegedly overstated the value of their trucks and rolling stock to banks and investors.
But the company was a good company for one person, for a few people that decided to be greedy or whatever. They screwed a whole lot of people.
Celadon claims it got caught in an industry downturn that has seen 640 trucking companies file bankruptcy in the first half of this year, according to industry analysts. Celadon would be the biggest trucking company to fold. Cummins, just down the road from Celadon in Columbus, makes truck engines and recently announced it would reduce its global workforce by about 2,000 employees in the first quarter of next year.
It's just not the truck drivers that are affected by Celadon going bankruptcy. It's also the employees and other companies that Celadon owned, not including, you know, the warehouses that trusted this large company to get their products from point A to point B. And with this being so close to the holidays, who can they turn to?
Insiders tell us that only a skeleton crew is going to stay on board to process paychecks and pay bills. On the east side, Russ McQuaid, CBS 4 News.
Celadon's chief executive released a statement saying a number of legacy and market headwinds made it impossible for Celadon to stay on the road. He goes on to say Celadon has faced significant costs associated with multi-year investigations into the actions of former management. He says Celadon had no choice but to cease all operations. Mayor Hogsett says he is working with community partners to offer short-term resources to Celadon employees. Those resources include help finding a new job and free personal financial advice. You can find all that information at cbs4indy.com.
A 15-year-old boy in Coco.